नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट स्टैंडर्ड 6 सोशल साइंस, चैप्टर नंबर 4, अर्ली स्टेट ऑफ पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम इन इंडिया।
स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी स्टार्ट न्यू लेसन अवर अर्ली स्टेट ऑफ पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम इन इंडिया। सो फर्स्ट वी विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अर्ली स्टेट। सो अर्ली स्टेट मीन्स prior state, before state, and political system means, if we want to tell that, it means government or governor. Governor means to rule all over country. How it is possible in early state of India, we are going to discuss about this in this video. So now, the thing is that if we are talking about the present time in India, so we have government and how government is elected. So the government is elected by the people, those who has complete 18 years or more than 18 years, so they can give the vote. And so early time, what is the system of India, we are going to discuss about that. We get information about the political system and institution from the Vedas, epics and Buddhist texts. So we get information from where we can get the information about political system. Political system means about that time government, and institution means sanstha. From the where we can get the information? From Vedas. So how many Vedas are there? Are 4 Vedas: Rig Ved, Yajur Ved, Sam Ved and Athar Ved. So there are 4 type of Vedas, and we already learn about that. Epics means long poem. And the Buddhist text means who is related to believe in religion of Buddha. So there, from the text also we can get all type of information of early state. There the political system we come to know from them. Rig Vedic period or Vedic period. Rig Vedic period means that the existence of Rig Veda time. And Vedic period means when the time of applicable. So from this, the statehood means the state connected each other. Statehood, statehood. So this is the statehood was similar to that kabila. Kabila rule means we all know the word kabila. Its head was called Rajanya. So there is a kabila. Kabila means there is a group of people. Rajanya, who was to be elected, and that time also some election type also were there. So the head of kabila is known as the Rajanya, who was be elected. And political organization like sabha and samiti existed. This community was also called Vish. Afterwards, different type of political system were implemented in India. So state would understand connected to each other, and they have two type in India. Now we have two type of government. First one is union government, and second is state government. State government is related to state, and union government, it is also known as a central. So that one is also known as the central. So there are two type of government. And that time, this community was also known as the Whigs. Afterwards, different type of political system were implemented in India. So, after head of Rajanya, political organization like Sabha, Sabha means meeting arrangement, and Samiti means group of committee. In also in the school also we can see some type of Sabha and Samiti is there. So their time also some type of Sabha and Samiti. In the Rig Veda period time, there is a Kabila, and who elected that one elected person is known as the Rajanya. And then political organization day by day there is also some changes. It is also known as Sabha and Samiti. And now in this period we have a two type of government, union government and state government. Union government is also known as the central government. Now our next topic is Janpad. So first understand what is the meaning of Janpad. Janpad means small group of state. That one is known as the Janpad. About 1000 BC, now you also know the meaning of BC. BC means before Christ. The earlier state of different clans. Clans means here also group of families who are related to each other. That one is known as the clan. Were established in Punjab and the Ganga River area. So before 1000 years ago, there is a clan and the families are living there. Where it is they are living? They were living at the Punjab and Ganga River area. There these were called Janpad. So it is known as the Janpad. Janpad was the area or place of a person habitat, means where Janpad means which place there is people were living together like a family. The word Janpad is used in the state sense of state, means it is also known as a state. So here also written small group of states, and in the state there are group of families who are living in the related to each other. So in the first before 1000 year ago before Christ, there were people living near the Punjab and Ganga River area. Janpad was state system that was very unique from clan society of Rig Vedic age. It included the state of different group like Kuru and Panjal. So first there was a group of people living, that one also in Rig Vedic time there is also known as Kabila. Then also again start it is also known as the Sabha and Samiti. And now in Janpad it is also known as the state, and also this state is also a clan or society. So many people, many families were living in the clan, and it is also of Rig Veda. In it is also after Rig Veda time it is also different kind of group like Kuru and Panchal. Now our next topic is Mahajanapad. Around the 6th century about 16 Mahajanapad have been found in India. Some of these Mahajanapad were republic while some were monarchy type of state. These Mahajanapad are outlined in the following table. There is also you can see some tables. One table is given. There are 16 Mahajanapad name, capital and current location also given. So what is Mahajanapad? Means there were about 16 Mahajanapad in India around the 6th century BC. People crashed. There were two type of governors. Republic. Now India it is in republic. And what is monarchy? Means king. King rule over the state or whole country. So that one is known as the monarchy, and India now is republic country. First we understand the meaning of Mahajanapad. Maha means big. Janpad means people. And Pad means state. So Mahajanapad means the Big people means there are too many peoples are living in the state, or otherwise we can use the meaning of group also. So many people of group, that one is known as Mahajanpad, and Janpad meaning is too small group of people. So now we can understand what is the difference between the Janpad and Mahajanpad. Mahajanpad means very big group of people, and Janpad is small group of people. Now there are 16 Mahajanpads, they are giving in the book, and there is Mahajanpad capital and current location are given. So one time we will revise that one. First one is Anga, capital is Champa, and current location is East Bihar. Second Bajji, capital Vaishali, and it is location is in North Bihar. Third one is Malla, capital is Kushinara, and location is area near Gorakhpur. It is located in Uttar Pradesh. Fourth one is Kashi, capital Varanasi, and it is also in Varanasi. It is located in Uttar Pradesh. Fifth one, Magad, Giriviraj, and Rajgiri. It is in South Bihar. Next is Kosal, it's Sharavati, Ayodhya. You also know the word of Ayodhya, where Lord Sri Ram was born. That one is Ayodhya, and it is also known as Awadh. It is location is also Awadh, and it is located in Uttar Pradesh. Next one is Vatsa, and capital is Kosambi, area near Prayagraj. It is also in Uttar Pradesh. Next one is Chedi, Suktimati, and the region between Yamuna and Narmada river. Next one is Panchal, that one is Ahichhatra and Kemalia. That one location is Badriyu, area near Barlia. It is also in Uttar Pradesh. Next one is Sushen, Mathura, and region near Mathura. Where it is Mathura? Lord Sri Ram was Lord Krishna was born in Mathura. Next one is Kuru, and capital is Indraprastha, and region near Delhi and Meerut. Asmaka, that one is, and capital is Pudanya, and it is on the bank of river Godavari. Next one is, it is in Avanti, and capital is Ujjaini, and region of Malwa. Matsya, and capital is Viratnagar, region of Jaipur. It is located in Rajasthan. Then Gandhar, and capital is Takshashila. What is Takshashila? Did you heard this word? Takshashila was a university, and region near Peshawar and Rawalpindi. Next, last one is Kamboj, and it is capital is Lajpur, and region near southwest to Kashmir. So here are 16 Mahajanpads name and capital, and where it is the location are given. So we will continue again. According the book of Anga Utra Nikaya, written in Pali language, there were 16 Mahajanpad in post-Vedic period. Some of the important tribes are shown in the map. So at the post-Vedic period, means previous Vedic period, that time where the Vedic period was current. So that time was, these 16 Mahajanpad were at that time, but it was written in Anga Uttara Nikaya book, and it is also written in Pali language.
Thank you for joining us.